And so Sarvantara can be one alone, Brahma also can be one. Brahma means limitless. Limitless also cannot be two. Sakshat means immediate, that also cannot be two. Aparoksha meaning, you know, direct, cannot be two. So Vasyaka Dvayoho, because the questions, both are asking these questions. In that they are using the same visheshana, the characteristics here, lakshanas. Dvayoho agamatva, atmatva, sarvantaratva, anupattehe. If these two atmas are different, at least the atmatva, sarvantaratva, agaunatva. What is agaunatva? Is aparokshatva. Sakshat is svaprakashatvam and aparokshat is agaunatvam. Aparokshat brahma or aparoksham brahma. Aparoksham meaning immediate, so direct. And so Bhashyakara explained that as agaunam. Not like manaha and then, you know, so srotram, etc. is looked upon as atma. This is atma, that is atma. So primary, this is a primary, this primary self, not secondary self. So primariness cannot be true, the innerness cannot be true, or the selfness cannot be true. That is why also we say that the two atmas cannot be different from each other.
Tadeva sphutayati, again, tadeva. Dvayoho tad anupattvameva sphutayati.
How there cannot be two mukhya, and there cannot be two sarvantara, and there cannot be two atma.
So, that itself is, sphutayati clarifies yadi iti. Yadi ekam agaunam brahma dvayoho itarena avashyam gaunena bhavitavyam tatha atmatvam sarvantratvam cha viruddhatvad padarthanam.
So yadi ekam agaunam brahma, let us say that Ushastri is asking about sakshad aparokshad brahma. So that Brahma is aparoksha, meaning agaunam, meaning mukhyam. So if one of them is agaunam Brahma, dvayoho, if any one of them is agaunam, meaning mukhyam, dvayoho itarena avashyam gaunena bhavitavyam, then this other one of the two must necessarily be secondary. Because mukhya or the principle, the primary one cannot be two. So if you say that these are two atmas, then we would have to think that one atma is primarily atma or primarily Brahma, then other atma must be secondary atma. Otherwise they cannot be two. It cannot be that both are primary atma and still they are two, because primariness cannot be two. So one is primary, then other has to be secondary. So yadi ekam agaunam, whichever one is agaunam, meaning primary, agaunam Brahma, primarily Brahma, dvayoho itarena, of the two. Sixth case, dvayoho itarena avashyam bhavitavyam. So one of the two must necessarily has to be agauna, meaning secondary. Gauna bhavitavyam. Tada atmatvam sarvantaratvam cha. Then atmatvam also should be secondary and sarvantaratvam also must be secondary. Both of them cannot be primarily so if they are different atmas.
Say Anandagiri, dvayoho madhye idi ekam brahma agaunam.
Between the two, if one Brahma is agaunam, meaning if it is primary, tada itarena gaunena avashyam bhavitavyam, then the other one must necessarily be the Brahma or Atma in a secondary sense. Tatha atmatvadi. So brahmatvam, atmatvam, sarvantaratvam, sakshatvam, etc. All of these have to be primary in one case, secondary in another case.
Tatha atmatvadi. Yadi ekasishtam.
If you desire that one of them is Atma, other must be accepted as an Atma, because both cannot, Atmatvam also cannot be two.
Tada itarasya anatmatvadi.
Anatmatvadi means anatmatvam, asarvantaratvam, amukhyatvam, aprakashakatvam. That way we have to accept that the two are different. They have, because Atmatvam and Mukhyatvam and Antaratvam cannot be two.
Tatraha,
jiti kudasyat. Why do you think so?
Tatraha, viruddhatva. Sevashyakara said, viruddhatvad padarthanam.
because padartha, what is 5, 5, 5? Anekatva mukhyatvadina. Anekatva, anatmatva, amukhyatva, anekatva, atmatva, mukhyatva, all of these are. So one is gauna, other is mukhya, they can oppose to each other. They cannot be together. Atmatva and anatmatva are opposed to each other. So viruddhatva padarthanam. Those padartha, meaning of those words, are totally contradicted to each other. Therefore, they cannot obtain in one locus. And so, if both are atmas, both atmas are different, then one atma must necessarily be opposed to or totally different in nature from the other atma, which cannot be.
Sri Ranagiri, Ukto Papadana Purvakam, Dvishravanasya Abhiprayamaha. Again, footnote number 10, Padartha Virodha Upapadana Purvakam Idibodhyam. Ukta meaning what? Padartha Virodha Upapadana Purvakam. That how then the Padartha will be totally contradictory? So that has been explained. Upapadana Purvakam, Dvishravanasya Abhiprayam, Prashna Punaruktehe Abhiprayam. So, Abhiprayamaha. And therefore, that is what is being said here. First of all, Bhashyakara shows, if the two atmas were different, how they would be contradictory in nature, and that being not the, that cannot being the case, therefore, what is the meaning of this repeating the question? Since the two questions meant two atmas, then they will be totally contradictory to each other, which cannot be, because atma of Ushastha cannot be totally opposed to atma of Kahola. Then that cannot be, therefore it must be a question about the same Atma. Then if the same Atma, then what is the meaning of repeating the question? Both this Vashyakara explains in the Yadi Ityadina.
Yadi Ekam Sarvantaram Brahma Atma Mukhya Itarena Asarvantarena Anatmana Amukhena Avashyam Bhavitavyam. So Vashyakara himself says that in so many words. Ekam Sarvantaram Brahma Atma Mukhya. So this Ekam Sarvantaram Brahma Atma and Mukhya. Mukhya. So Mukhya means Aparoksha, you know. And so if this applies to one, Itarena, the other Atma must be what? Asarvantarana, anatmana, amukhena, avashyam bhavitavyam. And then, other atma must necessarily be asarvantara, anatma, amukhya. So this ukta upadana purvakam, that is the, how the two are opposed to each other, that is being said. Then dvishravanam. So say anadi, aneka mukhyatva sambhavat. Inasmuch as primariness cannot be two, primariness has to be only one. अनेक मुख्यत्व संभवात् वस्तुतः परिच्छिन्नस्य घटवत् ब्रह्मत्व घटवत् अब्रह्मत्वात् वस्तुतः परिच्छिन्नस्य. And so in reality one of the atmas was limited, then वस्तु परिच्छेद परिच्छेद विशिष्टस्य. Then हाँ वस्तुतः परिच्छिन्नस्य means what? If two atmas are different, then one is not the other, other is not one. Then each one is limiting the other. So each one is limited in vastutva. That's what another thing, you know. Each one is limited in vastutva. Because chair is not table, and table is not chair. So that's what footnote number 12 said. Vastu paricheda visishtasya. Each atma becomes limited by vastutva. Vastutva meaning one is not the other vastu. Just as table is not the chair and vice versa. Therefore, vastutaha parichinnasya. That is how vastutaha means from the standpoint of vastu. So if their atmas are two, then they are each one of them limited from standpoint of vastu. Therefore, ghatavat abrahmatva, then they are not limitless. Then they are like ghatapata. Ghata is not pata, pata is not ghata. Just as ghatapata, each one is limited. Therefore, that atma also will become limited. They cannot be Brahman. Brahman means limitless. Anatmatvacha. And then if one is atma, other one has to be anatma. Ekameva mukhyam. Pratyek bhutam brahma. Therefore, brahma has to be only one. It cannot be brahma is atma as well as anatma. And so, brahma has to be atma. One of them anyway. And so, therefore, ekameva mukhyam pratyek bhutam brahma. Therefore, brahma is one. Mukhya means primary. Pratyek bhutam means of the nature of one's own self, or everybody's self.
This is how it should be. Kropatra says something about that. Ekameva mukhyam. See the footnote there. Ekameva iti prashnartha atma bhede doshantaram ahu vatikacharya. Another dosha. Ekameva iti, that's all. Then there should be a dash there. Prashnartha atma bhede. Prashnartha atma bhede. What is prashnartha? The meaning of the prashna. Who is atma? So prashnartha itself is atma. So Atma, who is the meaning of the Prashna of Ushastha and Kahola, if they are different, then in that case, Doshantaram. Not only the Dosha that Bhashyakara has pointed out, that there will be two Atmas and one is Gauna, other is, you know, Mukhya and so forth. So then another Dosha is pointed out by Vartikara, Tathahi. Vyartho Panishadarabdhihi, Arabdhihi, Yadi Bhedo Bhavetayoho, Anirmoksha prasaktischa kshetrajna paramatmanoho. Then in the fourth line you have to see the explanation of this. Brahmatmaikyam jnatam upanishadarambha. So the purpose of Upanishad is Brahmatmaikyam jnatam, to know the identity between Brahma and Atma is the purpose of Upanishad. Vastutaha tadbhede nasa arabhya. If in reality, if Brahma and Atma were different from each other, then Upanishad has nothing to contribute, really. So what does the only thing that Upanishad says, all these big Upanishads and everything, all the simple, a single thing that they say is, Atma is Brahma, that's all. This is all the Upanishads to contribute, really speaking, you know. We may study for years and years and years, but anyway, only one thing is said from on day one, and will be said on every day, until as many years as you study, is what? Atma is Brahma. I am Brahma. That means each one can say I am Brahma. That means everybody is Brahma. Everything is Brahma. And Brahma alone is, this is what is the subject matter for the Tatparya, purport of the Upanishad. Every Upanishad and all Upanishad. So Brahmatmaikyam jnatam Upanishad arambha. And so the commencement of Upanishad, The purpose of Upanishad being there is to convey this. Vastutaha tad bhede nasa arabhya. If in reality Atma is different from Brahma, then Upanishad, there is no point in Upanishad at all. Vinnayoho aikya jnana ayogad. Then na should belong aikya jnana ayogad. Vinnayoho. Now Upanishad keeps on saying that Atma is Brahma. If in reality Atma were Brahma, then that aikya jnana cannot be there. There cannot be knowledge of identity of Atma and Brahma because they are different. And therefore if somebody has a knowledge that, oh, Atma is Brahma, but then that would be false knowledge. If Atma were different from Brahma, and if somebody comes to know that Atma is Brahma because of Upanishad, that would have been no meaning at all. Ayogad. Even if you have the best kind of knowledge, if it is not the knowledge true to the nature of the things, that knowledge doesn't help at all. And so I may have the knowledge that this is made of gold, let us say, you know, this pot is made of gold. That's a wonderful knowledge. I saw that this pot is made of gold. That's wonderful knowledge, but not useful at all, because it is not knowledge in keeping with the nature of the things. So, bhinnayoho aikya jnana ayogat. And therefore, if the two are different, Atma and Brahma are different, the aikya jnanam, the knowledge of identity is not possible, and even if somebody comes up with it, then it will have no meaning at all. But somebody says, no, the experience is that Atma is not Brahma, but that is only Kalpita. Bheda meaning the duality that we experience between one another, and duality that we experience between Atma and Brahma is only Kalpita, is only imaginary or projected, then it's okay. Kalpita bhede prashnayoho na bhinnarthada. If the bheda or the duality or division between Atma and Brahma is kalpita, meaning it is only imaginary, then the two questions are not different, because in reality they are one alone. So that is what Vatikara says. Vyartha Upanishad Arabdhi. Arabdhi is Arambha. Arabdhi, you know. So anyway, Ti Pratyaya is applied. So to Arabha, if you apply T, then becomes Arabdhi. That same as Arambha.
So Vyartha Upanishad Upanishadah Arabdhi. The Arambha of the Upanishad, so is Vyartha, becomes useless. Yadi Bhedo Bhavet Tayoho. Yadi Tayoho Brahmatmanoho Bhedahvai Brahmanatma are different, then the Upanishad commencement, Upanishad is meaningless, is useless. Then says the Tika there, Kincha Jiveshvarayoho Vastuto Bhede Jivasya Brahmatvakyo Moksho Nasyat. And if jiva were really not Brahman, then there cannot be this state, you know, or there cannot be this situation that jiva knows himself as Brahman. He cannot be, because he is not Brahman. And then that is called moksha. To be Brahma Veda, Brahma Iva Bhavati, the knower of Brahma becomes Brahma. But knower of Brahma will not become Brahma if knower is not Brahman. The knower of Brahma then will become the meditator of Brahma, or realizer of Brahma. That means he sees Brahman as someone different from himself, but there cannot be becoming a Brahman, in which case there cannot be moksha in the primary sense. So, jivasya brahmatva kyo mokshanasyat. Then, there cannot be moksha of the nature of jiva, in fact, discovering himself with Brahma, because they are different. That's avidyakshaya. And there cannot be avidyakshaya, meaning there cannot be cessation of or dispelling of avidya, because then it is not avidya also. I at the moment think that Brahma is different from me. And if Brahma were really different from me, then that knowledge of mine is not Brahma, it is Prama, is reality, then there is no ignorance. Then there is no ignorance to be dispelled also. Tasyabhi tvat pakshe hetu abhavat. Because avidya also doesn't remain the hetu. We say that avidya becomes the cause of this Brahma, the delusion of creating division between Atma and Brahma. But if that division were real, there is not Brahma. In that case, there is no avidya at all. So avidya is only presented as a hetu or the cause of this Brahma. Hetu abhava deva yogat atah aphalam shastram anarabhyam. And therefore, aphalam shastra, meaning shastra does not give rise to any phala, does not give rise to any kind of a result, or any does not serve any purpose at all. And therefore, anarabhyam, it should not be commenced, it should not be studied also. So anirmoksha, that's what the second line of the verse said. Anirmoksha prasaktischa. Prasakti means prasanga. Anirmoksha prasaktischa. And anirmoksha prasakti. There will be occasion of anirmoksha, there will be no moksha at all. Kshetrajna paramatmanoho. That kshetrajna paramatmanoho anirmoksha. That is interesting anyway. So kshetrajna sa anirmoksha prasanga. Kshetrajna. So all Kshetrajna Paramatmanah Bhedah Bhavet. That is how you have to connect. Kshetrajna Paramatmanah Bhedah Yadi Bhavet. If Kshetrajna and Paramatma are different, then Adir Moksha Prasakti. Then there is no moksha at all. That's how. Then the Tika continues. Vastav Atma Bhedah Bhavet Hetvantramah. That in reality there cannot be a difference in Atma. Vastav Atma Bheda Bhave. The two Atmas are different, or Atma is limited. See, if Atmas are different, then each Atma becomes limited. So Bheda means limitation. That Atma cannot be limited, for that another reason is being. So this is also nice reason. Different kind of dosha is pointed out by Vartikara here. That's why it's being presented here. Vastav Atma Bheda Bhave Hetvantaram. Another hetu, the reason is being stated as to why Atma cannot be limited, akrusna yadi. So the verse says, akrusna drishti vishayah nishedhopi na yujyate pravishtasya cha nachaikarsnyam vijnanatma na ishyate nachaikarsnyam vijnanatma na ishyate. Right. So akrusna drishti vishayah nishedhopi na yujyate nishedha. So Tika explains, Saha yota ekaikam upaste nasaveda akrasnohi saha. That came all the way in 147, you know, in the 7th kandika. So what is it? Pranandeva prana bhavati vadan vak pashyan chakshuhu. Sae shaiha apravishta anakhagrat. So what is it? Anakhagrebhya. So he has entered this all the way up to the tip of the nail, you know. And so, that means the Atma has entered this Upadhi and occupies the entirety. Therefore, there cannot be many atmas, or therefore, atma which pervades everything cannot be incomplete. So, prana or prana, if somebody thinks that atma is only prana, or a drashta, or a shrota, or a manta, then that, these are all the functional names of the atma. And then if someone knows atma as merely a seer or hearer or thinker, then that is incomplete knowledge of atma.
Saha yata yaha ata ekaikam upaste.
Upaste means knows. If one knows atma is either drashta, shrota, manta, etc., nasaveda,
then he does not know the atma. So in its entirety, akrishnohi eshaha or akrishnohi saha,
because then atma is incomplete. Then one knows atma is incomplete self, therefore one doesn't know the atma. In that case, so this kind of a vision of taking the atma as shruta, manta, vijnata, this vision has been actually has been condemned.
Nisheda.
So nasaveda, this fellow doesn't know. Akrishno hi saha, because he knows atma is an incomplete one, and therefore he does not know. So this kind of knowledge of knowing atma as a limited entity, this knowledge has been condemned. That means that atma cannot be limited. Had atma been limited in reality, then there is no reason to condemn that vision. But the fact that the incompleteness, the vision of the incompleteness of atma is condemned, meaning that atma is not incomplete, atma is complete.
Akrishna drishti vishayah nishedhopina yujyate.
Therefore, that nisheda or condemnation of this kind of knowledge of taking atma to be an incomplete being, that condemnation would not be justified had atma not been complete. So atma had not been complete, this nisheda would not be justified.
Pravishtaschana chet katsnyam.
And so the one who is entered, anakagrebhya, that's the one who is entered all the way up to the tip of the nail. And then, if that one who is entered in this body, had it not been a complete being, nachet karsam, karsam means completeness. We have not been complete. So,
vijnanatmana ishyate. Pravishtasya nachet karsam vijnanatmana ishyate.
In that case also, we have to say that the one who has entered is not complete.
So, pravishtasya chet karsam vijnanatmana ishyate. If this is what it is,
so chet means, if this is what you have to say, that one who has entered, that vijnanatma, is not a complete being, in that case, that nisheda would not have been justified. The fact that nisheda is done, that shows that the one who has entered this body is a complete being and not an incomplete being.
Atma bhedam nirasya prasangat anatma vedam apunudati.
Alright, atma vedam nirasya. Having thus refuted the duality of the atma,
prasangat anatma vedam apunudati.
Vartikara says that just as atma veda is not there, even anatma veda is not there, even anatma is also not there. In fact,
vastu iti. Vastu vrittanarodhena nato vedosti kutrachita. Vastu vrittana bhijnanat bheda svapnendra jalavat. Vastu vrittana anurodhena,
because of the anurodha, or the vastu vritta, meaning in keeping with the nature of the thing,
na bheda atah na bheda asti kutrachit.
In fact, nowhere is there any kind of a division at all. Nowhere is there any kind of duality. Even atma and anatma, that duality also is not there. All there is atma alone.
Srishtika atma aparichinnatvam atas shabdartha.
That atma is limitless. Limitless cannot actually entertain a second. So when it, something, whatever is limitless cannot have something different from it is, because in that case, limitless must necessarily be all-inclusive. Then only it can be limitless. All-inclusive means nothing is excluded. If limitless also excludes something, if there is something outside the boundary of limitless, in that case, it is not limitless at all. In order for the limitless to be limitless, nothing can be outside its boundary, nothing can be excluded by that, it cannot be opposed to anything, it must encompass everything. It must accommodate or encompass or include everything. Therefore, even anatma cannot be different from atma. It is only in the beginning that this duality of Atma and Atma is accepted to, you know, in order to eliminate the Atma Buddhi in Deha, etc. What happens is, when there is Atma Buddhi in the Upadhi, then Atma becomes limited. Therefore it is said that Upadhi is not Atma, this is not Atma, there is not Atma. That is how one knows the Atma to be transcendental reality, then one knows that immanent also is Atma. So since immanent alone is taken to be Atma, therefore to release this fellow's, you know, notion, this is being said that you are not this, you are not this, you are not this, it is true. Because it is not real. Unreal is taken to be real. Then unreal cannot pose a duality with reference to the real. Therefore the anatma which is unreal is kalpitam. And kalpita creation cannot actually create a duality in Brahma, which is Adhisthanam. Then says the Tika, Vastu Cheda Parichinnam Katham Paricheda Bhanam Varmanam Tatraha. So, Paricheda Bhanam is better. If Vastu is limitless, how come then we seem to experience limitedness? If Atma were really limitless, how come I seem to experience it as a limited being? Or if there is all that there is non-duality or oneness, how come I seem to experience duality or manyness? And then the answer is given, Vastu Vrutta Anabhijnanat. It is Anabhijnanat. It is because of ignorance of the Vastu Vrutta, means the nature of Vastu or the nature of reality. It is because of the ignorance of the nature of reality that one entertains the notion of this sense of limitation. Bheda Swapnendra Jalamata. But if it is not there, how can I have Bhanam? The question was, if the duality is not there, how can I experience duality? If the manyness is not there, how can I experience that which is not there? Then example is given, Bheda Swapnendra Jalamata. Just as in Swapna, Endra Jala. In dream I see and experience things that are not there. So it is not there, I cannot necessarily experience something that is not there. I can experience because I can project. It is not that I am experiencing something which is not there. I am projecting something which is not there. And then calling it an experience. So I am projecting the duality, projecting a sense of separatedness, and then taking it to be real, and then suffering from that sense of reality. So, Bheda Swapna Indrajalavata. Indrajala means the magic. In magic also, what is not there is projected. In dream also, what is not there is projected. So just because you have the experience of duality does not mean that the duality has to be there as in dream. And therefore, we have to say that the so-called experience of duality or a sense of limitation is not a manam, is not a reality, it is Brahma, it is a delusion which is a product of ignorance. Vastuvritta anabhijnanan. It is not knowing the nature of thing, the nature of reality, that this notion of duality is created. Atma bheda prasnaikyam phalamaha. Thus if Atma bheda, if Atma is one, then prasnaikyam. The result is what? It amounts to saying that prasna is pertaining to the same Atma. Both the questions, meaning Ushastha and Kahula, both of them are asking about the same Atma. That is the idea here. And still there is no Punarukti. Even though they are asking about the same Atma, because there may be more than, you know, what is stated earlier to be known, there can be something more to be known. You can ask about the same Atma because something more is to be known. That's all. And so the verse, Eka eva tatah prasna. Na prasna dvaya mishade. Therefore we say that the prasna is one alone, that means both the questions pertaining to one Atma alone, and not that they are asking about two different entities. So in a different way, Vartikara explains why the subject matter of both the questions is one alone, because all these other doshas will be there. So doshantaram, those doshas were all stated, must have been stated, that Bhashyakara has pointed out. This Gaunam and Agaunam, etc. Or that cannot be two Atmas in one Upadhi, etc. But then, other doshas will be there if we accept the multiplicity of Atma. So, going back to Anandagiri, last line.
यदि जीवेश्वर भेद अभावात् प्रश्नयोः न अर्थ भेदः तर्हि पुनरुक्तिः अनर्थिका इति. ऑल राइट, देन somebody says, यदि जीवेश्वर भेद अभावात्, since jiva and ishvara are not different, there is no duality between them, prashnayoho na artha bheda, and therefore the two questions do not refer to different entities, they refer to the same entity, tarhi punarukti anarthika. Then why should there be punarukti? Why should they ask about the same atma? What's the need of repeating that question? So if the atma is one, we do not see any purpose of repeating the question. Iti ashankya ha. That ashanka is replied to Bhashyakara, tasmadadi. Tasmad ekaseva dvishravanam vishesha vivakshaya. Tasmad therefore, footnote 1, atma parayoho bheda bhavena prashnayoho artha bheda bhavat. See, the atma and paramatma not being different, therefore the prashnas are also not referring to different entities. Therefore, ekasyeva dvishravanam. Dvishravanam is punarvachanam. It is one atma alone that is being repeated again. Why? Vishesha vivakshaya. Footnote number 3. Vishesha vivakshaya. Anukta vishesha kathanechaya. Some vishesha was not stated earlier. Anukta. And therefore, kathanechaya, with the desire to bring out the other vishesha, the other characteristics of Atma. One characteristic of Atma is that it is different from this Karyakarana Sangata, different from gross and subtle body. This was what was brought out in the Ushastra Prashna. But there is another characteristic of Atma that was not pointed out there. What is that? That Atma who is different from this Karyakarana Sangata is in fact Brahma. So that Vishesha was not brought up, not pointed out there, or not mentioned there, or not stated. Therefore, in order to state that Vishesha, is the purpose of the second question. So Yajnavalkya only said this much. Na drushtehe drashtaram pashyehe. First of all, the existence of Atma was established. Yav pranena pranidhi apanena apanidhi, etc. So that because of it, the prana is able to breathe, and apana and vyana and udana, that because of whom all of these are able to perform their functions. And therefore one who is not among them, one who is different from them, and one who is chetana, all of these are jada. And the jada cannot be actually be active or performing functions unless they are presided over by a chetana entity. Therefore, there is a chetana or a conscious self or conscious being because of the prana, apana, etc. functioning. And then, na drushtehe dashtaram pashyehe. That way, specifically it was said that one cannot actually perceive the atma by the organs of perception or by the mind. That means that there is an atma who is witness or illuminator of all of them. And so, this much was said there. Yajnavalkya did not say everything there. So then Kahola knows that, wait a minute, there is something more to be said. Let us see whether he knows it or not. So this much Yajnavalkya knows that Atma is different from Karyakarana Sangata, but does Yajnavalkya know whether Atma is Brahma or not? Therefore he asks, yat sakshad parokshad brahma, ya atma sarvan, yadeva sakshad parokshad brahma, ya atma sarvan tarah, tanme vyachakshveti. Ishate atma sarvan tarah, katumo Yajnavalkya sarvan tarah iti. So wants to know, Kahola wants to know whether Yajnavalkya knows this other aspect of Atma or not. Anukta vishesha kathana ichchaya, with a desire for stating the vishesha, the characteristic of the Atma that was not stated in the reply of Ushastra, with a desire to say that, is the Shruti presenting this question again. That footnote continues, taduktam vartike. Kanchid visheshaṁ apekṣa, visheshaṁ apekṣa, not apekṣa, I guess. Prashto bhūyobhi pruchyate iti. Kanchid visheshaṁ apekṣa, with an apekṣa of some other visheshaṁ, prushta, even though asked one, bhūyobhi pruchyate. Even though Atma was asked about, bhūya, again Atma is asked about, with an expectation of stating another visheshaṁ or another characteristic. So Atma pruchyate iti sheshaha, that Atma is asked about, even though he was asked once by Ushastra, he is again asked about by Kahola with this intention of knowing some other vishesha, other characteristic. Then continuing this page 795, says Anandagiri, tarhi saiva visheshaha darshayitavyaha. All right. तरहि सैव विशेषः दर्शयितव्यः. तर्हि मीन्स् विशेष विवक्षा पुनरुक्तिश्चेदिति. सो विशेष विवक्षा पुनरुक्तिः विशेष विवक्षा मीनिंग् इफ पुनरुक्ति हैज़ अ विवक्षा ऑफ प्रेजेंटिंग सम डिफरेंट विशेष और कैरेक्टरिस्टिक देन सैव विशेषः दर्शयितव्यः देन याज्ञवल्क्यः शुड हैव प्रोसीडेड टू से दैट येन पुनरुक्ति अर्थवति इति आशंका है. ऑल राइट देन यू शुड से दैट तर्हि सैव विशेषः दर्शयितव्यः येन पुनरुक्ति अर्थवति इति. If you say that the same question is asked second time in order to say some different characteristic, then you should point, then you should tell us. What is that vishesh of the characteristic? Yena punarukti arthavati bhavet. So, only when that vishesha is there, then the punarukti, meaning repetition, would become meaningful. What is that vishesha? So, yattu, Bhashyakara says, yattu puroktena समानं द्वितीये प्रश्नांतरे उक्तं तावन्मात्रं पूर्वस्यैव अनुवादः तस्यैव अनुक्तः कश्चिद् विशेषो वक्तव्य इति. सो दैट इज व्हाट आई से फॉर यत् पूर्वोक्तेन समानं द्वितीये प्रश्नांतरे उक्तं द्वितीय प्रश्न उक्तम प्रश्नोत्तर उक्तम इन द सेकंड क्वेश्चन. सो पूर्वोक्तेन समानम पूर्वोक्तेन मीनिंग उशस्त ब्राह्मणोक्तेन प्रश्नोत्तरेण. सो प्रश्नान उत्तर इन द उशस्त ब्राह्मण. सो दैट पोर्शन विच इज आइडेंटिकल टू द उशस्त ब्राह्मण. सो होल क्वेश्चन इज आइडेंटिकल एंड पार्ट ऑफ द आंसर ऑल्सो इज आइडेंटिकल. एषते आत्मा सर्वांतर कथो याज्ञ सर्वांतर अप टू दैट पॉइंट. That part of the whole question as well as the part of the answer are same in both in the previous and the new Brahmana. So, yattu purvoktena samanam. Samanam in tulyam kahola brahmanasta prasnottare uktam. And so, whatever is same in both of them. Dvitiye prasnantare uktam. Footnote number 6 says, prasnantare desyasthane prasnottare iti paatha. The paatha is prasnottare उक्तम इन सेकंड प्रश्नोत्तर तावन मात्रम पूर्वस्यैव अनुवादः. इट इज नॉट दैट द होल पैसेज दैट इज कहोल ब्राह्मण इज अनुवाद ऑफ द उशस्त ब्राह्मण. ओनली पार्ट ऑफ दिस पैसेज अनुवाद मीनिंग रेपिटेशन और रीटरेशन ऑफ द प्रीवियस पैसेज नॉट द होल थिंग अदरवाइज इट वुड टोटली बिकम पुनरुक्ति. सो तावन मात्रम मीनिंग उक्त प्रश्न परिमाणम. And so that part of the prashna, parimanam, that part of the prashna and that part of the answer, that much alone is purvasev anuvadaha. So eshate eshate atma sarvantara, that also is anuvada. So because sarvantara atma is being talked about. Tavan matram purvasev anuvadaha, up to that point alone is anuvada or reiteration of the previous brahmana. Tasseva anukta kaschid vishesha vaktavya. Tasseva anuditasya atmana. What is anudita? Anudita means what? So of which anuvada has been done. Anu plus udita. Anu means paschat. Or again, udita means so kathitaha. So that which has been stated again. So otherwise anudita had been unudita. If nu were rasva, then the atma that is not stated. Is dirga, atma that is stated again. Tasseva meaning anuditasya atmanah, and so that atma that is stated again. Anuktaha kaschid vishesha vaktavya, and kaschid vishesha, some characteristic that has not been stated, vaktavya, that characteristic must be stated. Iti. Iti footnote of mine, vishesha vivakshayadi purvatra anvayah. इति विशेष विवक्षया द्विश्रवणम्. सो दिस द्विश्रवणम् ऑन द पुनरुक्ति इज इन ऑर्डर टू से सम विशेष दैट हैज बीन नॉट स्टेटेड इन द अर्लियर प्रश्नोत्तर. श्री आनंदगिरी अनुक्त विशेष कथनार्थम उक्त परिमाणम निर्णेतुम उक्तानुवादश्चेत् अनुक्तो विशेषः तर्हि प्रदर्श्यताम्. ओके
अनुक्त, दैट इज अनुक्त और अनुदित विशेष कथनार्थम. इफ यू नॉट स्टेट द विशेष और द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक दैट इज नॉट बीन स्टेट इन द प्रीवियस पैसेज, उक्त परिमाणम निर्णेतुम, उक्त मीनिंग उक्त परिमाणम मानकम प्रश्नम, सो दैट पार्ट ऑफ द क्वेश्चन एंड आंसर निर्णेतुम उक्त अनुवाद चेत. And so, oh, all right, Dhananuvada, that means questions are not totally identical. The words are identical. Even questions are not totally identical. They refer to same entity. But the intention is different. So what Kahola intends is to extract from Yajnavalkya another kind of a characteristic not covered by the answer of to the Ushastha. Answer to Ushastha, what was not covered is the intention of Kahola. To get that out, you see. And so in that sense, even that desire to get something more out is contained in Kahola Prashna, the fact that he repeats. The fact that he repeats the same question means that he is not satisfied totally with the answer to Ushastha. That means he thinks that there is something more to be told about Atma, which Yajnavalkya has not told, and therefore to find out whether he knows that or not is the purpose of Kahola. And so even though Kahola repeats the same words, he still has the intention of getting something more. So even there also Vishesha is there. Even though the words are repeated, the intention behind the words is somewhat different here. So ukta parimanam nirnetam ukta anuvadaschet. And so ukta anuvada, that anuvada is for that. So anukto visheshah. So tarhi pradashyatam, then please point out or please show us what is that vishesha, what is that characteristic that is not stated in the earlier one that is being stated by Kahola. Iti prachyate. Kaha iti? Kaf punaha aso visheshaha iti? So somebody is asking Mahashikan, all right, what is that vishesha which was not stated earlier, which is being stated here? What's the vishesha meaning? What is the difference? Kidri. Bubhutsitam vishesham darshayati. Bubhutsa. Buddhum iccha. Bubhutsitam. So, buddhum ishtam. So, that which is desired to be known, vishesham, that vishesha which is desired to be known, darshayati, Mahashyakara point. Shows here, uchyadeti. Uchyade. पूर्वस्मिन् प्रश्ने अस्ति व्यतिरिक्त आत्मा यस्यायम् सप्रयोजको बन्धवुक्त इति. द्वितीये तु तस्यैव आत्मनः अशनायादि संसार धर्मातीतत्वं विशेष उच्यते. Uchade, so that Vishesha being said, Purvasmin Prashne in Ushastha Prashna, Asti Vyatirikta Atma, that is established. Asti Vyatirikta Atma. Vyatirikta meaning Pramatradi Vyatirikta Tat Sakshi. Pramatradi. Not only Karyakana Sanghada, but Pramatra. Pramatra means a knower, means Ahankara. There is an Atma even different from Ahankara. When we say different, you should not understand difference in the sense of Ghata being different from Pata, you know. By different, we only mean difference in reality, that's all. When Lord Krishna says, the world is not different from me, but I am different from the world, that means that I enjoy a reality that is different from the reality of the world. That is the difference. So when we say that Atma is Sakshi of Anatma, don't think that Atma stands apart from Anatma and is looking at it or gazing at it or something like that. It's only that Atma enjoys a reality that is not enjoyed by Anatma, that's all. So difference there is not difference in time or space, it is a difference in the degree of reality. That is why the difference can be recognized only when the anatma is dropped. And so, aham iti nasha bhaji, aham aham taya. And therefore, when there is a nasha, or a complete cessation of what is mithya, then what is satyam shines in its true reality. So, pramatradi vyatiriktas, vyatiriktah, tat sakshi. Pramatradi vyatiriktah. one that is separate from the pramatra, pramatra, pramiti, pramanam and prameyam. So knower, known, knowing and knowledge, one who is different from all of them. Meaning this knower, known, knowing, knowledge, all that vyavahara has a certain reality which is what we call vyavaharika sattva or mithya reality. And tad vyatiriktaha, one who is different from that, not different in sense of space or time, different in sense of the degree of reality. Of whom these are all reflections. Of whom these are all the vesha, the different roles. So same Atma, the Sakshi, he himself becomes Pramata and Pramiti and Prameya and Pramanam with the reference to different Upadis. So with the Upadhi of Ahankara, that same Atma becomes Pramata. With the Upadhi of Chakshu, etc., he becomes Pramanam. With Upadhi of Namurva, he becomes Prameya. With Upadhi of Antahakarvati, it becomes Pramiti. So, same Atma comes to be called by different names because of the different Upadhis. But in reality, the one who appears in all the different costumes is different from all of them and is necessarily... It is purely a superimposition, you know. He may not want to discard his costume as that of a rich man, you know. He may hesitate to do that. This he'll gladly discard. The costume of a beggar, he'll gladly discard. The costume of a rich man, he may not discard. He may not want to discard. Even at night also he'll wear something, you know, which demonstrates his richness. Even that kind of whatever night suit he wears, that will be different from the night suit put on by other people, you know. And that means the richness he doesn't discard. The beggarliness, when we say that he discards the costume, that beggarliness he can discard totally, without leaving even a trace. But the richness will always leave trace on him, even if he has no costume at all. Even if he doesn't wear anything, still the richness is there. In fact, that itself becomes a demonstration of richness very often, you know. I mean, so the point is that richness being his nature can never be discarded, and beggarliness, even when he wears that costume, he can discard it by not identifying with it, that's all. And so, being a beggar is a superimposition. It is superimposition alone that can be discarded. There is no way that we can discard that which is real. You cannot negate it. That negation is a make-believe stuff. So I can make-believe myself that I am, you know, all my problems are there, and I can make-believe that I have no problem. That's a make-believe. I can manage to forget it by drowning myself in something else. It's just waiting. Like this, these flies are waiting, you know. And there were sometimes this poor buffalo, 10,000 flies, you know, on its head. And therefore, to avoid those flies, it just dips, you know, its head in the water. So flies have to run, they fly away. They are waiting there, you know. No sooner the head comes out, they all land right on there, you know. And similarly also, the so-called problems, which we think are not, which we want to disown, we cannot disown something that is real. Regardless of what you do, unless it is recognized the problem is unreal, okay. We recognize that the problem is unreal as much as the cause of the problem is unreal, which is ignorance, then alone it is possible to disown the problem. Otherwise, if I think that the cause of the problem is real, the problem also is real. And disowning would become only like burying my head in the sand, you know, like an ostrich. Or it can be simply deluding myself. Or it can be being dishonest with myself, whatever it is. But then, so what we are saying is, as long as the world is real, so long the problems created by the world are real, and so long there is no point in saying that there are no problems, you know. So when somebody says to Swami, I have no problem, Swami would say, that is a problem. To say that I have no problem itself becomes a problem, because you can say I have no problem provided you know that I am that which is beyond all the problems, then it's okay. But even that very statement, I have no problem, itself hides or conceals many things, you know. The need to say that I have no problem just shows, you know, that there are some problems inside. But that doesn't mean that when someone says I have no problem, there is a problem. There is no such thing. Point is that that which is real cannot be discarded, that's all. And so something can be discarded only when it is not real. So tad vyatiriktaha, tad sakshi, that means that sakshi means one who is devoid of all these kind of notions. Sakshi means one is devoid of the idea of pramatrutvam and prameyatvam, etc. And so, said Bhashyakara, purvasmin prasne, asti vyatirikta atma. So this was established that there is an atma over and above the pramata. That's it. So my knowledge of the atma goes up to pramata. My knowledge of atma goes up to ahankara. Therefore, I may know myself as a knower, or as an enjoyer, as a doer, as an experiencer. That is in the maximum I can go with reference to my perception. And so, therefore, Shruti alone can establish asti vyatirikta atma, that there is an atma over and above this pramata. Yasyayam saprayojako bandha. Of whom there is too much volume, you know. So yasyayam saprayojako bandha. Yasya atmanah ayam saprayojako bandha. For whom, for which atma there is saprayojaka, along with prayojana. Karmadi prayojakam. So saprayojaka. Prayojaka in a saha vartara said, there is a bondage along with this karma, etc. So karma is the prayojakam, meaning which perpetuates actually. Karma is not the cause of bondage. Karma is the symptom of the bondage which perpetuates the bondage. Yasya ayam saprayojako bandha uktah. It was stated earlier. So grahadigraha lakshana bandha, that was stated for this atma. So first three brahmanas actually talked about bondage. For whom? Bondage of this atma who is the karyakarana sanghada vyatirikta and pramatradi sakshit. For that atma, the bondage, namely the grahatigraha, was stated earlier. So that atma is of whom the bondage was stated in the first three brahmana. Therefore the fourth brahmana established that there is an atma for whom there is bondage, and that is sakshi of all this. Iti. Footnote number 12. Iti purvasmin prasne uchyate iti anvayah iti. So purvasmin prasne uchyate iti. Iti uchyate. The uchyate is what? Iti uchyate. Bhashyakara said uchyate first. That should have been said at the end. Purvasmin prasne asti vyatirikta atma yasyayam saprayojaka bandha ukta iti uchyate. That's all. But uchyate is said first in order to create a comfort in this person, the uchyate. Don't worry, there is an answer here. You know, uchyate. Then what is it? Then fine. Otherwise, if uchyate comes at the end, I don't know what he is going to say. And therefore, uchyate. What is vishesha? What is the vishesha? Uchyate. That is being said. So he knows that it is vishesha that is being said. And so he orients himself to listen to that vishesha. Okay, then, dhritiyedu tasiva atmanah asanayadi samsara dharma atitattvam vishesha uchyate. Dhritiya meaning in kahola prasna on the other hand. So, tasiva atmanah, or the same atma who was established as different from karyakarana sanghata, for whom it was said that there is this bondage, for the very same atma, a vishesha of the distinction or characteristic of asanayadi atitattvam, asanayadi samsara dharma atitattvam, asanaya pipasa, shoka moha jara mrityu, that all is samsara. So that there is an atma who transcends all this dharma of the samsara. All of these are superimposed upon the atma. That vishesha is being said. Then says Andri, kimit esha vishesha nirdishyate tatra. All right, what's the need? When it was said already that there is an vyatirikta atma, what was the need of stating this vishesha? That is asanaya pipasa atiriktaha etc. or atitaha. So Bhashyakara says, yad vishesha yadi. Yad vishesha parijnana sanyasa sahitat purvoktat bandhanat vimuchyate. Yad vishesha parijnana. It is very necessary to know that vishesha. Yad vishesha parijnana. The not only atma is different from karyakarana sanghata, but that he is Brahman. By knowledge of that, sannyasa sahitat parijnanat. So that knowledge, along with the sannyasa, uroktat bandhanat vimuchyate. So one gets liberated from that bandha or the bondage of grahatigraha by knowing the atma who transcends this samsara dharma. And so, had it not been stated, moksha would not have been possible. Partial moksha is there, by knowing that I am not this body. But still, I know myself as different from other atmas. That is not enough. So I must know that I am Brahma, limitless. And then alone, one gets liberated from bondage. So says Anandagiri, artha bheda asambhave phalitamaha. Artha bheda asambhave prashnayoho, that these two questions cannot be of different atmas. These questions pertain to the same atma, and so it is not possible that there are two different atmas. Phalitamaha, so tasmat. So what it amounts to, says tasmat. Tasmat prashna prativachanayoho eshata atma ityayamantayoho tulyasata eva. Tasmat, therefore, that we'll have to see tomorrow, that footnote, but tomorrow, therefore, prashna prativachanayoho, of the question and the answer, eshata atma ityayamantayoho, of the question and answer, up to this section, eshata atma sarvantara, up to that point, tulyasata eva, up to that point, they refer to the same entity, they refer to the same atma, and not different atma. Finally, he says there, yah ashnaya ityadinatu vyakshita vishesha uktihi iti sheshah. Oh, I see. Vishesha parijnanat. Yah ashnaya ityadinatu vyakshita vishesha uktihi iti sheshah. Iti ityadina granthena. Yah ashnaya ityadina granthena tu vyakshita vishesha uktihi. That should be added at the end. So, yeshada atma sarvantara, up to that point, the atma and the meaning is the same. Beyond that, yeh ashnaya ityadinatu, beginning from there, to vivakshita vishesha uktihi. From there begins the ukti or the statement of vishesha or the distinction which is intended to be stated. That also should be added. So, up to that point, there is the sameness, but after that point, these vishesha are being stated. Okay.
Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah. Ishvaro Guru Ratmedi Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyomavat Vyapta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namah. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namah. Hari Om. Asahainam kaholah kaushidake yah paprachya. Yajnavalkye diho vacha. Yadeva sakshad aparokshad brahma. Ya atma sarvantarah. Tamme vyachakshveti. Eshara atma sarvantarah. Gatamo yajnivalkya sarvantarah. Yoshanaya vipase shokam moham jaram ratyumatyede. Etam vetam atmanam viditva brahmanaha. Putraishanayascha vittaishanayascha lokaishanayascha vittaya. Adha bhikshacharyam charante या ह्येव पुत्रैषणा सा वित्तैषणा या वित्तैषणा सा लोकैषणा उभेह्येते एषणे एव भवतः तस्माद् ब्राह्मणः पाण्डित्यं निर्विद्य बाल्येन तिष्ठासेत् बाल्यं च पाण्डित्यं च निर्विद्यास मुनिः अमौनं च मौनं च निर्विद्यास ब्राह्मणः स ब्राह्मणः केन स्यात् येन स्यात् तेनेदृशैव अतोऽन्यदार्तम् ततोह कहोलः कौशीतकेय उपरराम
So question was whether what is asked by in this passage by Kahola, is it the same question as, meaning the subject matter of the question Atma, is it the same as asked by the earlier one Ushastra, or the Atma referred to here is different? This is the question. Tasmad bhinnameva atmanau kshetrajna paramatma akhyo idikejit vyachakshate. Some people, namely Bhartrupapancha and his followers, say that these two questions refer to different atmas. The earlier question referred to Kshetrajna, that is Jivatma. This one refers to Paramatma. Tanna tehi pratijnana, that cannot be, because in each one it is said, esha te atma sarvantarah. It is yourself, that is sarvantarah, the self of all, and that is the sakshad, aparokshad, brahma, sarvantarah. Eshadatma edhi prativashane pratijnyadam. In each of the replies, pratijnyadam, this has been proposed that it is your atma that we are talking about. Nachekasya karyakarna sanghadasya do atmanam upadyate. It's not possible that one karyakarna sanghada, te means yours, meaning of this karyakarna sanghada, it cannot be that there are two atmas of one karyakarna sanghada. Eko hi karyakarna sanghada, ekena atmana atman. Because we know that one karyakarna sanghada, the gross and subtle body, is in fact lent the selfhood or consciousness, sentiency, by one consciousness, by oneself. Then somebody said, however, Ushastra could have one atma, Kahola could have another atma. Nicha Ushastra sanyaha, Kahola sanyaha, jatitaha, bhinna atma bhavati. It is not that Ushastra has a consciousness as atma and Kahola as some other one as atma. It cannot be. Jatitaha means svabhavataha. Because aham aham iti ekakara spuranat. In each one of them the atma shines aham aham in the same way. And therefore we cannot imagine that the atmas of the two are different. And therefore the first question was a reply to the atma of Ushastra, and the second question is a reply of atma of Kahola. That cannot be.
Dvayoho agaunatva atmatva sarvantaratva anupattehe.
And furthermore, if both atmas are different, then each one cannot be sakshad, aparokshad, brahma, sarvantara. Each of the atmas is qualified as sakshad, aparokshad, brahma, sarvantara. Two things cannot be sakshad and aparokshad and brahma and sarvantara.
Dvayoho agaunatva atmatva sarvantaratva anupattehe.
Two entities cannot be sarvantara. Both of them cannot be the innermost. Only one can be innermost. And Brahma means limitless. Two cannot be limitless. One alone can be limitless. Sakshat, immediate. Two things cannot be immediate. One has to be immediate. Aparokshat, direct. Ragavanam, the principle of primary. Two things cannot be primary. Each one of these words is opposed to duality. Meaning, each one of these words is opposed to two things being that. So, anekatva meaning two, and sakshatva, aparokshatva, they cannot go together.
Yadi ekam agavanam brahma dvayoho itarena avashyam gaunena bhavitavyam.
If of the two, one brahma is gaunam or primary, other one has necessarily got to be secondary. Atmatvam sarvantaratvam cha. If one is atma, other must be anatma. If one is sarvantara, other must be asarvantara.
Viruddhatvat padarthana,
because anekatvam, being more than one, and again being sarvantara, etc., they cannot be together.
Ekam sarvantaram brahma atma mukhya itarena asarvantarana anatmana amukhyena avashyam bhavitavyam.
Thus, if one is atma and sarvantara and brahma, the other must be necessarily different from that. And in this case, different also the opposite.
Thus, and that cannot be. Tasmad ekasyeva dvishravanam vishesha vivakshaya.
Then Vashyakara said, the reason why the same question appears to be asked again is because some vishesha, some more specific things about the same atma needs to be known, and that is why question about the same atma is asked. You need not say the same question is asked. The question about the same atma is asked because Kahola has the desire to know something different about that atma as compared to what was replied in case of Ushastra.
Yaktu puroktena samanam dvitiye prashnantaramuktam tavanmatram purvasyeva anuvadaha.
So yajnivalkye di hovacha. So beginning from there, of course, atha kahola kaushitakeha papracha, that is alright. Yajnivalkyeti hovacha yadeva sakshad parokshad brahma yatma sarvantarah tanme vyachakshveti yeshadatma sarvantarah katumo yajna sarvantarah. Up to this point both the passages are similar.
Yattu purvoktena samanam dvitiye prashnantare uktam.
So the second question and answer also, whatever is the same as in the previous one.
Tavan matram purvasyeva anuvadah.
Up to that point we should understand anuvada, the repetition or reiteration of the first question
in answer both. Tasseva anuktaha kaschid vishesha vaktavyaiti.
Then why are you repeating that? Anuktaha kaschid vishesha vaktavyaya. Some vishesha or something more about it, which has not been stated in the previous case, has to be stated. Why? That also we say. Why should we say that? Kaf punasau vishesha. First of all, what is that vishesha or the distinctive characteristic that needs to be stated?
Uchare purvasmin prashne asti vyatirikta atma yasyayam saprayojago bandhukta iti.
So in the earlier question was established that there is an atma different from karyakana sanghara. Who is the sakshi of this karyakana sanghara, for whom there is this bandha along with this prayojaka, namely karma. This was determined in the answer of the previous question.
Dvitiyetu tasseva atmanaha ashanayadi samsara dharmadi tattvam vishesha uchade.
The second reply, on the other hand, question and reply, for the same atma, asanayali samsara dharma atitattvam visheshaha, that atma is not merely sakshi, but is asanaya pipasa shokam moham and jaram rutyam atyedi. That it transcends all the samsara dharma.
So samsara dharma atitattvam visheshaha uchade.
Not only that atma is untouched by the karyakana sanghada, but that atma transcends all the dharma of samsara, that also has to be stated. Why should we state it? Yad vishesha parijnanat sasanyasat sasanyasa sahitat purvoktat bandhanat vimuchyate. So, yad vishesha parijnanat, when that vishesha or that specific further characteristic is known, then parijnanat sanyasa sahitat, when the knowledge takes place along with sannyasa, purvoktad bandhanat vimuchyate, then one becomes liberated from the bondage that was stated earlier, bondage of nature of this grahati graha lakshanam.
Tasmat prashna prativachanayoho eshtatma ityamantayoho tulyasadayava.
That means that the question, and up to that point eshtatma sarvantara, up to that point it refers to the same atma and does not refer to different atma. And still there can be repetition because some vishesha has to be stated.
Now page 796, continuing.
There was one footnote there on page 796. Tasmat prashna prativachanayoho eshatatma ityavantayoho tulyasada eva. And therefore, the prashna and prativachanayo tulyasada up to that point. Tasmat. Now see footnote number one there. Tasmat iti.
Ushastra kahola prashnottarayoho asabheda asambhavaditya tasmat.
Tasmat,
उशस्तक कहोल प्रश्नयोः अर्थभेद असंभवात्। Because it's not possible that they have asked questions about two atmas, because two atmas cannot be both Brahma and Sarvantara and Sakshat and Aparoksha, and therefore it's impossible. Also, there cannot be two atmas of the same Karyakarana Sanghata, and therefore, then the two atmas refer to are different is impossible. Ushastra kahola prasnotrayo arthabhed asambhavat, because these two prasna and uttara, I mean two subject matters, cannot be different. Then the footnote says, vishesha jignyasaya prasnantara pravritti muktva. Prasnantara pravritti. The pravritti of the second question is vishesha jignyasaya, to know something more about the atma other than, more than what was stated in the first case. Prasnantara pravritti muktva. Prakarantarena api, so Vartika also accepts that and describes that in the Vartika. Then having said that, Prakarantarena api, tat pravritti mahu Vartike. So Vartikacharya even gives another reason. So one reason is what? Vishesha jignyasaya prasnantara pravritti. This is one thing. Vishesha jignyasaya, with a jignyasa, desire to know some vishesha, something more. Then Vartikar explained that there is another reason, one can see another reason also as to why the same question is asked again. Yatha prasnam prativasyo na sammigditam pura iti matva thva prakshid ushtamartham punarvashim. Yatha prasnam prativasyo na sammigditam pura. That's interesting. Pura meaning the first case when Ushastha asked the question. Yatha prasnam prativasyo na sammigditam. The reply of Sage Yajnavalkya was not quite in keeping with the question of Ushastha. He did not give a reply that could totally cover the question of Ushastha. Did reply all right, but did not cover everything about what Ushastha asked. Iti matva, this is what Kahola thinks. Athva means the second paksha. Aprakshit prushtamartham punaha rushim. And there were prushtamartham punaha aprakshit. And so, the same prushtamartha meaning, the same thing has been asked again. So, Kahola asked the same thing again. Rushim to Sage Yajnavalkya, the same thing has been asked. That's what the Tika says in the sixth line. Kasam yaha prasnam prativatihana uktam. Then you ask, yes, why do you say that? Katham vidha prasnam prativajana uktam. Why do we say that? The reply of Sage Yajnavalkya was not in keeping the question. The second verse is, Sakshadityadina prushtam, Sakshadityadilakshanam, yatha sambhavyate nedrag, pratyukto kinchidikshate. See, Ushastha asked, yat sakshad aparokshad brahma, idi prushtam, Sakshadityadilakshanam yatha sambhavyate, na idruk pratyukto kinchi dikshate. We do not find anything pratyukti, we do not find anything in the reply, which actually sambhavyate. In the reply of Sage Yajnavalkya, we do not see any kind of a description or any kind of a statement which actually explains this sakshad aparokshad brahma. We do not find, at least in this, in the case of Sage Yajnavalkya, I mean Ushastha reply even. So we do not find that Sakshad, Aparokshad, Brahma, all that has been properly answered. So characteristics of Atma that have been stated by Sage Yajnavalkya do not seem to bring out this. And so, Eshada Atma Sarvantaraha, Yaf Pranena Praniti Apanena Apaniti, etc. And so, we don't Pranena Praniti, that because of which the Prana breathes and Apana, so Prana, Apana do all their functions, that doesn't explain Sakshad Aparokshad Brahma. And Ushastha further asks, which one do you want? Yeah, I asked you to show me specifically what Atma is. Na Drishtehe Dashtaram Pashyehe, and so forth. And so, you cannot perceive the perceiver. Then also, whether Sakshad Aparokshad, this specific question of Ushastha doesn't seem to be dealt with. Meaning that Sage Yajnavalkya's reply does not seem to specifically deal with this aspect of Ushastha's question, that it is Sakshad Aparokshad. Sakshad Ityadina Prushtam ಸಾಕ್ಷಾತ್ ಇತ್ಯಾದಿ ಲಕ್ಷಣ ಯಥಾ ಸಂಭಾವ್ಯತೆ. ಇವನ್ ಇಫ್ ಯಾಜ್ಞವಲ್ಕ್ಯ ಡಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಯೂಸ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ವರ್ಡ್ ಸಾಕ್ಷಾತ್ ಪರೋಕ್ಷಾತ್, ಬಟ್ ಸ್ಟಿಲ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ಹಿಸ್ ರಿಪ್ಲೈ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೀ ದಟ್ ಯಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ರಿಪ್ಲೈ ಟು ಸಾಕ್ಷಾತ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅಪರೋಕ್ಷಾತ್ ಎಟ್ಸೆಟ್ರಾ, ದೆನ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ದಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬಿನ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಲಿ ಡೆಲ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್. ಬಟ್ ಯಥಾ ಸಂಭಾವ್ಯತೆ ನ ಇದ್ರಕ್ ಪ್ರತ್ಯುಕ್ತೌ ಕಿಂಚಿದೀಕ್ಷತೆ, ವಿ ಡು ನಾಟ್ ನ ಕಿಂಚಿದೀಕ್ಷತೆ ಪ್ರತ್ಯುಕ್ತೌ, ವಿ ಡು ನಾಟ್ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ದ ರಿಪ್ಲೈ ವೆರಿನ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ದಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಟು ಉಶಸ್ತಾಸ್ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಸಾಕ್ಷಾತ್ ಅಪರೋಕ್ಷಾತ್ ತತ್ವ. ಅಸಂತೋಷ ಹೇತು ಮುಕ್ತ ತತ್ ಫಲಮಾಹ. ಸೊ ಅಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಲಿ ಕಹೋಲ ವಾಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಸ್ಯಾಟಿಸ್ಫೈಡ್ ವಿತ್ ದಿ ರಿಪ್ಲೈ ಆಫ್ ಸೇ ಜಾಜ್ಞವಲ್ಕ್ಯ ಟು ಶಸ್ತ್ರ. ಅಸಂತೋಷ ಹೇತು ಮುಕ್ತ, ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಹೇತು? ದ ರೀಸನ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಸಂತೋಷ ಡಿಸ್ಸಾಟಿಸ್ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ದಟ್ ದಿ ಸಾಕ್ಷಾತ್ ಅಪರೋಕ್ಷಾತ್ ಎಟ್ಸೆಟ್ರಾ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬೀನ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಲಿ ಡೆಲ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್. ತತ್ ಫಲಂ, ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಡಿಟ್ ಕಹೋಲ ಡು? ಅಸಂತೋಷಾದ ಅಸಂತೋಷಾತ್ ಕಹೋಲೋತ ಉಶಸ್ತ ಪ್ರಶ್ನಮೇವತು. ಅಸಂತೋಷ ಇ ಸ್ಯಾಟಿಸ್ಫೈಡ್ ದ ರಿಪ್ಲೈ ಕಹೋಲ ಅತ ಉಶಸ್ತ ಪ್ರಶ್ನಮೇವತು ಭೂಯ ಅಪ್ರಾಕ್ಷೀತ್. ಎಂದರ್ ಸೇಮ್ ಭೂಯ ಅಗೇನ್ ಅಪ್ರಾಕ್ಷಿತಾಸ್ತ್ ಉಶಸ್ತ ಪ್ರಶ್ನಮೇವತು, ಸೇಮ್ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಉಶಸ್ತ, ದೆನ್ ಕಹೋಲ ಆಸ್ಟ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಅಪ್ರಾಕ್ಷಿತ್ ಮುನಿಂ ಆಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸೇಜ್. Then says the Tika, yatha prashnam prativachah na uktam ched ushastheneva prashtavyam. If you, who is Kahola to decide that? That say Jagnyalkya's reply was not proper or not in keeping with the question. Because ushastah chakrayana upararama, ushastah son of chakra, he became silent. That means he was satisfied with the reply. How can Kahola determine that he is not satisfied? That's it. ಯಥಾ ಪ್ರಶ್ನ ಪ್ರತಿವಚನ ಉಕ್ತಂ ಚೇತ್, ಇಫ್ ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಯು ದ ರಿಪ್ಲೈ ವಾಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಇನ್ ಕೀಪಿಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ದಿ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್, ಉಶಸ್ತೇನೈವ ಪ್ರಷ್ಟವ್ಯಂ, ದೆನ್ ಉಶಸ್ತ ಶುಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಪರ್ಸ್ಯೂಡ್ ಫರ್ದರ್. ವೇಟ್ ಎ ಮಿನಿಟ್, ಹೌ ಆರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಹೌ ಆರ್ ದಟ್? ಯು ನಾಟ್ ಡೆಲ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ದಟ್. ಕೆಲವು ಅನ್ಯ ಪೃಚ್ಛತಿ, ಹೌ ಕಮ್ ಕಹೋಲಾ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಟೇಕ್ ದ ಇನಿಷಿಯೇಟಿವ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್? ನೌ ಕ್ಲಾರಿಫೈ ದಟ್. ತತ್ರ ವಿದ್ವಾನ್ ಭೂಯೋಪ್ರಾಕ್ಷೀನ್ ಮುನಿಂ ವಿದ್ವಾನ್. Apparently Kahola is Vidwan and Ushastha may not be. That's right. That may be the reason. That means, and so Vidwan iti. Kahola prashnasya prayojanamaha. All right. So if he asked again, what is the purpose of Kahola? So answer is yathatmya artha va buddhaye. Yathatmya artha va buddhaye. A buddhaye for the knowledge of artha, of the meaning, yathatmya, of the atma as atma is. In order to know the true nature of the atma, then Kahola repeated the question of Ushastha. Then says, asat pratyuktya ushastha prashnasya nirnitatvad na santosha hetuhu. He says, wait a minute, Ushastha asked twice. When, by the first reply, Ushastha was not satisfied, then Ushastha asked again, says, wait a minute, your answer is like that cow is that which walks and horse is that which runs, and I do not want the answer by this linga or the indication, I want directly what Atma is. Not the Shrotrasa Shrotra Manaha Mana, what is that Atma? Same discussion was raised in Keno Upanishad also. So, Asakrat Pratyukta Pratyukta. So, Ushastha asked more than one, the reply also was given more than once. Ushastha Prashnasya Niranitatvat. Therefore, you cannot say that the reply, the Ushastha's question has not been properly dealt with. Na santosha hetu hasti. And therefore, we do not see any reason for dissatisfaction. Iti ashankyaha esha iti. Esha atmedi pratyuktihi yaf pranayenedi chapara tavan matroktito nasau prashnartho vadhrito bhavetiti. ಏಷ ಆತ್ಮೇ ಪ್ರತ್ಯುಕ್ತಿ. ಸೊ ಏಷದ ಆತ್ಮ ಸರ್ವಾಂತರ ಅಂಡ್ ಯಹ ಪ್ರಾಣೇನ ಪ್ರಾಣಿತಿ ದಟ್ ಪ್ರತ್ಯುಕ್ತಿ ದಟ್ಸ್ ಯಹ್ ಪ್ರಾಣೇನ ಪ್ರಾಣಿತಿ ಚಾಪರ ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ರತ್ಯುಕ್ತಿ ದಿಸ್ ರಿಪ್ಲೈ ತಾವನ್ ಮಾತ್ರೋಕ್ತಿ ಮಿಯರ್ಲಿ ಬೈ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಯೋರ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪ್ರಾಣ ಅಪಾನ ಎಟ್ಸೆಟ್ರಾ ಪರ್ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ದ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ತಾವನ್ ಮಾತ್ರ ಉಕ್ತಿ ಮಿಯರ್ಲಿ ಬೈ ಸ್ಟೇಟಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಮಚ್
न सौ प्रश्नार्थ अवधृतो भवेत्। प्रश्नार्थ है, सो व्हाट प्रश्नार्थ मीन्स आत्मा, दैट आत्मा कैन नॉट बी प्रॉपरली एसर्टेन्ड मेरली बाय दिस मच रिप्लाई ऑफ याज्ञवल्क्य, एंड दैट्स रीजन फॉर असंतोष, दैट इज वाई कहोला आस्क द सेम क्वेश्चन अगेन इन ऑर्डर टू डिटरमिन द ट्रू नेचर ऑफ द आत्मा। दिस इज एन ऑल्टरनेट एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ वाई कहोला रिपीटेड द क्वेश्चन ऑफ कुशस्थ। सो सेज द टीका तथा च पृष्ठस्य अर्थस्य सम्यक् अनिर्धारितत्वात् तथा च देयरफॉर टू सो पृष्ठस्य अर्थस्य आत्मा वाज आस्क्ड अबाउट सम्यक् अनिर्धारितत्वात् एंड दैट वाज नॉट प्रॉपरली डिटरमिन्ड तन्निर्धारेश निर्धारितम् इच्छा इन ऑर्डर टू असर्टेन द ट्रू नेचर ऑफ द आत्मा भूयः तत्रैव प्रश्नोपत्तिः इति शेषः। देयरफॉर तत्रैव द सेम थिंग देयर कैन बी द सेम क्वेश्चन बीइंग आस्क्ड अगेन because this was not determined in the first case, I think. Okay. Now we proceed further. Sri Ranangiri, ekameva atma tattvam adhikritya prashnavad yatra chodayati, ekameva atma tattvam adhikritya, that there is only one atma tattva adhikritya, so the subject matter of both the question is same atma tattva. In the prashna, that the two questions were asked pertaining to the same atma tattva, iti atra chodayate. Again, a question is raised. It says, wait a minute, how do you say that? Maybe the second atma is the one that is beyond asanaya pipasa, and the first atma is the one that is endowed with asanaya pipasa. Why not? Apparently, there are two atmas, one possessed of the hunger and thirst and all the samsara dharmas, and the other one is beyond that. So, maybe these two questions and replies refer to different atmas. Nanu iti. So, question is asked here. Nanu katham ekasyaiva atmanah ashanayade atitattvam tadvatvam cheti viruddha dharma samvayitvam iti. Nanu katham ekasyaiva atmanah. How can it be that one atma alone, the very same atma, ashanayade atitattvam, that one atma is beyond the ashanaya pipasa, jara mrityu shoka moha, tadvatvam cha, and being possessed of the ashanayade also, iti viruddha dharma samavayatvam. Samavayatvam is innate nature. How can it be that one atma by its own innate nature is both possessed of the hunger and thirst and is beyond hunger and thirst also? How can it be? Why do you say that the same atmas are asked about? Maybe the two atmas we are talking about, one possessed of the hunger and thirst, and another being beyond that. That's how it looks like to us. See, footnote number 2, kathamidi, tamah prakashavat ekatra sambhavitam. So, viruddha dharma samvayitvam. This contrary or mutual exclusive nature, this mutual exclusive nature cannot obtain the same locus. Like light and darkness cannot obtain the same locus also, hunger and freedom of hunger, etc., cannot obtain the same locus. So how can it be? Then says Anandagiri, viruddha dharmatvat mitho bhinna prashnathavideta dushayati. Then this prashna and the artha are different because the atma, the possessed of the contrary nature, is prashnathav iti dushayati. So that is being faulted here by Mahashakara Naiti. Tava prakasha drishtanta anusandheha. So, viru mitho bhinno tava prakasha vat prasnartha. Okay. Naiti. Na parihirtatvat. In fact, this question is asked in order to understand how come I experience hunger and thirst. If, as you say, the atma is beyond hunger and thirst and jara and mrityu and so forth, how come I experience and how come everybody seems to experience? How to explain this simultaneously, that atma is beyond this, at the same time, this is what one experiences about the atma. So that seems to be contradictory. My experience seems to contradict the statement of the Shruti. How to explain that? Na parihrutatvat. Is it not that the atma is possessed of this contrary nature? that now he is possessed of hunger and thirst, and then he goes beyond hunger and thirst. Why not? That maybe Atma, when it is in samsara, is possessed of hunger and thirst and jaramrityu, and that when it becomes liberated, that it becomes free from hunger and thirst. Why not? So that Atma is really bound and really possessed of a samsara dharma, and something happens, this is what we call moksha, the liberation, and then he becomes free from all these dharmas. Why not? So either this refers to two different Atmas, or maybe it refers to two different states of the Atma. That you have to say. Sisna Parihutatvat, you already dealt with earlier. This contradiction, apparent contradiction in the nature of the Atma, that question has already been dealt with earlier. Where? In such an ocean, you know, where do you deal with, you know? Thank Parihutatvameva Prakatayati. Thank God, Bhashyakara, in fact, he may ask you to go back and refer, you know. So he doesn't expect that we should forget what all we have studied. But Parihutatvameva Prakatayati, at least briefly, he is kind enough to say that. That's always the style. So, not that you keep repeating the whole thing again, but at least you definitely give enough indication for people to recollect. Yeah, that's right. We remember, no, this kind of a discussion did take place. So, Namarupa, same thing is brought out here, Namarupa. Namarupa vikara karyakarana lakshana sanghata उपाधि भेद संपर्जनित भ्रांति मात्रम हे संसारित्वमिदे असकृदवोचाम असकृद. Not once, any number of times we have said this. Whenever the opportunity arises, we have been saying it. नाम रूप विकार कार्य करण लक्षण संघात उपाधि भेद संपर्क जनित भ्रांति. आनंद गिरी एक्सप्लेन दैट नाम रूप तयोः विकार हमें नाम रूपयोः विकार है. दिस उपाधि कार्यकरण लक्षण संघात है. दिस नाम रूप विकार कार्यकरण लक्षण संघात है. दिस कार्यकरण लक्षण संघात दिस उपाधि पजेस्ट ऑफ द कार्य एंड करण द ग्रॉस एंड सटल बॉडी इज नथिंग बट द विकार और मॉडिफिकेशन ऑफ नेम एंड फॉर्म. So it is a kind of a name and form. So name and form is a general principle. And every particular name and form is a modification or a manifestation of that general principle called name and form. So nama rupa yoho vikara hai, karya karana lakshana sanghata hai. That sanghata characterized by karya and karana, and that is a modification of name and form. Upadhi saiva upadhi, upadhi bheda hai. So that alone is variety of the upadhis. So what we call upadhis, the personalities or limiting adjuncts are nothing but the modifications of names and forms. Then samparga, tena samparga hai. Atma comes in contact with upadhi. So atma is in contact with or united with. So there is a union of this atma and the upadhi. What kind of union is that? So aham mama adhyasa hai. Not that Atma can really be united with the Upadhi, that is Karyakarana Sanghata, but Tasmin Aham Mama Sangha Adhyasa. In this Upadhi Adhyasa, or the superimposition that I am this Upadhi, or this is my Upadhi, this Adhyasa superimposition is what we call Samparka, or the contact that Atma has with Anatma. There is no contact. Just as the space cannot have any specific contact with anything, otherwise space will be affected by what it contacts with. So even though everything is accommodated in space, space is not in any way contaminated because space is asanga, unconnected. And similarly also everything is an atma or consciousness, but the atma or consciousness does not touch or contact anything in a primary sense, because otherwise it is bound to be influenced by that. And so the only kind of contact that atma has with anatma is tasmin aham mama adhyasaha. Only this aham, I and mine, that kind of a notion that is created because of identification. Tena janita abhrantihi. From the adhyasa superimposition, abhranti or this delusion is born. Aham karta ityadya abhrantihi. I am the karta, I am bhokta, and so whatever is done by the upadhi is done by me. So ahankara vimudhatma karta hamiti manyate. Although even though the actions are all performed by the upadhi, the one who identifies upadhi thinks that he is performing them. So, ahankarta ityadya, that is the bhranti. Bhranti matrami samsaritvam. Tavan matram samsaritvam. That alone is called samsaritvam. That I am a karta, bhokta, sukhi, dukhi, all of this. So kartrutva is no problem. Bhoktrutva is no problem. Sukha dukha are no problem. So, but then I am karta, I am bhokta, I am sukhi, I am dukhi. This is the result of the adhyasam. Those two things that belong to different adhikaranas are lumped together in one adhikarana. So, vayadhikaranam. In fact, these things don't arise, I mean, don't belong to the same adhikarana, same locus. Which I am karta, aham belongs to atma, karta belongs to anatma. Aham and karta belong to two different adhikaranas or to different locuses. And still, they are lumped together and thought to be obtaining in one locus, and therefore, that kartrutvam that belongs elsewhere is thought to be belonging to atma. The examples were given, just as a sphatika or a crystal. So, appears to be red, where redness belongs to flower and crystal is different. But then both of them are lumped together, because then for that arises a bhranti of the notion that crystal is red. Iti anekashah vipaditam asakrit avochama. It says, we have said this so many times. So it is anekashah vipaditam. Not only has been said number of times, but said it differently. It is not that we have said same thing again and again. But this has been actually, vipaditam has actually been explained or has been argued about in different ways. Tasmat nasti visvastutah virudh dharmavattvam ityartha. And therefore, you cannot say that atma is possessed of this totally contradictory characteristics. Vastutah, in reality. Says footnote number 5, kalpanikam tu tanna virudham iti bhavah. That somebody thinks that atma is ashanaya pipasa atidah. Somebody knows, and somebody else thinks that atma is possessed of asanaya pipasa. There is a rare fellow who says, so I am beyond asanaya pipasa, sarvasamsara dharmati toham, etc. You know, satchichidananda rupaha shivoham shivoham. Somebody says that. Another fellow says that I am sukhi, I am dukhi, samsari, etc. And so, apparently two contrary things are said about atma. So, kalpanikam dutanna viruddham. One of them is kalpana. To take oneself.